Well, I'm standing here in the nursery pavilion with the Duckworth Lewis Method, who have made a very, very nice song about, well, one or two things that happen in cricket. But how did it all come about, fellas?
Well, Neil, do you want to take up on that question?
Oh, you're passing the buck, are you? Well,
our love of you.
Basically, our love of cricket and ELO. And you marry those two things, and this is what you come up with, really. We were just, you know, we both live in Dublin. We both have our own bands, and we wanted to write songs together. We didn't really know what to write about, and we thought, what do we like? Cricket, you know? So that's what we wrote about.
So the song itself, and I have to say, I found it very amusing. And a lot of people have asked me, well, you know, crikey, you must be upset with those guys. I said, well, actually, no, it's actually a very funny song, and, you know, it did happen. So, but how did you find out all the words for it? Where did you get all the words from? Because they all sort of rhyme, and it's nice, and it works very, very well.
Cricketpedia.
there was a lot of helpful information on the internet, but, you know, we watched it at the time. And to be honest, you know, it's kind of a caricature. It's slightly sort of pantomime-esque, you know, in the song. So it's not to be taken terribly seriously. Also, I don't...
Yes, the one thing.
The one terrible inaccuracy is that I had to put, you know, you're out for a duck, because that rhymed.
Because it rhymed.
And you weren't, were you?
No, I actually got four.
You got four?
Yes, we want to apologize
I'm so
for that.
Sorry.
Well, that's all right. I mean, as I say, it is always poetic license, but no, it's absolutely magnificent. I know there's a lot of people that have actually enjoyed it enormously. What have the sales been like?
Well, it's been going great. We've just done a wonderful tour. A few gigs back in Ireland now in November, but it's been amazing. We've played the full houses every night, and we have a lot of fans.
And both the albums charted, you know, in the UK.
Yeah, and the new album is called?
Sticky Wickets. Yes. Wonderful, terrible cliche, but it had to be done.
And the cover is a certain Mr. Michelangelo, who famously jumped the stumps here in his nip.
Yeah, I saw that on the cover. It looked quite interesting.
And we managed to dig him up out of the woodwork. He's been coming to the gigs. He loves it.
Yeah. And he's made a comeback. Now, what about ELO? Because I'm a fan of ELO. When we travelled and went around the world, we used to listen to loads of people. Elton John, you know. We had Genesis and Phil Collins and just many, many others that used to keep us going. So the love of ELO, Jeff Lynne?
Yeah, Jeff Lynne's a huge influence on us. And, you know, makes you even more cool, Mike. You like ELO, trust me.
We had no idea how cool you were.
So that makes it even better for us. He's got back to us and said he really likes the record, because he is a cricket fan as well, you know.
Yeah.
So, you know, also Neil did it, narrated an excellent Jeff Lynne documentary for Radio 2.
Oh, yeah.
And I released my last Pugwash album he really loved, so he sent me a letter from LA.
We're just waiting for that perfect day when we manage to meet the man himself. Yes.
Well, I have to say, I was a fairly youngish man when I saw the ELO concert at Wembley, where the spaceship and the top came off and the lights.
Wembley, very cool.
It was very good. So it was one of the early concerts I went to see. So
you made your debut in 78, I think, didn't you? Yes, indeed, I did in Karachi.
Well, it was a good year for everybody, but wonderful group. But great, guys, I hear you're going to entertain us this afternoon. I shall look forward to you actually doing the song, I hope.
I hope
you won't let everybody down and not do it.
If you want to demonstrate visually on stage, you'll be most welcome.
I can certainly miss it again, because every time I see it, and I've seen it 1,000 times, I still keep missing it. You'd have thought I might have hit it once, wouldn't you?
No, it was
a fluke. Fluke.
You know, you're part of history in a lot of ways. You know, it's a great player.
And you're a very good interviewer as well.
Fellas, look, great to have you. I know we're going to start the dinner, but wonderful to see you here, and I shall look forward to hearing the song and listening to your new album. So thanks very much.
Pleasure,
made our
Mike.
Day.
Thank
thanks,
you.
Mike.